Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can print reverse of a string. So I will be explaining this concept with the help of two different methods, right? So before starting of the explanation, I want to share one information. If you go to detail or description of this video, you will find set of links related to playlists. Those are available on my channel, and those playlists are related to C programming videos. So you can follow them if you want to watch more programming related videos. So now I'm going to explain this method number one first. So let's say we have one string. And the content is India, right? So reverse means we need to print this A, I, B, then N, and then I. So this should be the output, right? So I am taking this as str. So starting the program. So I am declaring a character array. Let's say its size is 10, right? Now I'm going to take two variables, I and L, then printf enter string, then I'm going to read it through getS, so str, right? So this way I have received the input from the user. Now I'm going to first calculate how many characters are available in this string, because I need to print A first as output, then I, then D, and so on. And in case of a string, we don't know how many characters will be entered by the user, but we know after input, the last character will be having null character after that last character. So we just need to identify where null character is available so that we can identify how many characters are there. So we can do counting in two ways. Either we can iterate a loop, or we can use a predefined function, that is strlen. So as of now, I am going to use that predefined function. So this predefined function is available in string.h, string.h header file. So you need to include this header file before main function. So I think this is very easy. You can write yourself. So this L will be having a total length. So in this case, we have total 5 characters. So length will be 5. So we have total number of characters available that are 5. So now you can see we have value L as 5. So we can start loop from 4. So here I am writing I equals to L minus 1. I need to repeat a loop till 0 and I minus minus. And here I can print percent C str of I. So here you can see length is 5. So 5 minus 1 will be 4. So I will be initialized with 4. 4 is greater or equals to 0. That is true. So 4th index value will be printed on output screen. And see it carefully, I am using percent C here. So percent C always print a single character on output screen. So it will print A, then I will be decreased. So its value will be 3. 3 is greater than equals to 0. So str of 3 is having I, so it will be printed. Then again, I will be decreased, so it will be 2. So D will be printed, then I will be 1. So N will be printed, then I will be 0. Again, this condition is true, so I will be printed, and then I will be decreased to minus 1. That time this condition will be false and the output will be in front of you. So this is the first method that I explained you. In that case, we received as input a string in str, and then we printed its reverse. So here you can see we are printing that string in reverse order. But actually, it is not having the content in reverse order, right? So my method number two will tell you how you can reverse the locations of these characters within the string, and then how we can print that string without any loop in reverse order, right? So I'm erasing these. So for method number two, I will implement a logic to swap characters. So I will be swapping these two positions. So I will be swapped with A, and A will be swapped with I. So it will happen. A will become here and I will come here. Right? And this way I will swap these two, and the middle one will not be swapped. So if we have odd numbers, if we have odd locations, so one swapping will not be done. But if we have even positions, like if we have six characters, then all three will be swapped with other three. So this way it will be reversed. So this will be the output, right? So India is reversed here, and we can just print this str so that we can have output. So we can print this string without any loop. So now I will tell you how you can swap the elements within the string. So I am writing initial values. So this is the actual string that we need to reverse. So here you can see I have identified the length. So length is 5. Now I'm going to start loop from 0. And here I am using j as l minus 1. And I'm declaring one more variable as j. And then I'm putting a semicolon. So here you can see I'm putting comma in between. So I is starting from 0 and j is having l minus 1. So j is having value as 4, right? And this is the loop condition, then I plus plus comma j minus 1. So this is the loop. Then inside this loop, I am going to apply the logic for swapping the characters. So I am declaring one more character variable t. So t equals to str of I. Then str of I equals to str of j. And str of j equals to t. So this way the characters will be swapped so that we can have reverse of string. So starting from the beginning, so I is 0 and j is 4 because of this. L is 5, length is 5, so 5 minus 1, so j is 4. Now check this condition. I less than j, it is true. Now this swapping will be performed. So A will be here and I will move to here, right? So in first rotation of this loop, two characters are swapped, right? Now I will be incremented, so I will become 1, and J will be decremented, so it will be 3. So again, check this condition, I less than J, it is again true. So 1 index and 3 index will be swapped. So 1 is having N and 3 is having I, so I will be here and N will move here. So two rotations are completed of this loop. Then I will be incremented to 2 and J will be incremented to 2. Check this condition, 2 less than 2, it is false. So no further rotations will be taken place. So this loop will be terminated, and here you can see string is reversed with this loop. And after completion of this loop, you can print reverse equals to percent s and str. So without any loop, you can directly print that string. So the actual string is being reversed through this logic, and we are printing that one. So the original order of that string is gone, and the reverse one is available. So you can use that. So this was method number two. So in some scenarios, you just need to print the string in reverse order. So in that case, you can apply method one. In some scenarios, you need to reverse the actual string in memory location. So in that case, you can use method number two. So I hope you understood how we reversed, or how we printed reverse of a string that is provided by the user. With these two methods in C language, And I hope you explained, sorry, I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. And if you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel and go to playlist and see various variety of videos. Also, you can go to detail or description of this video, where you will find links of various playlists related to C language on my channel. So you can watch that too. So thank you for watching this video.